Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala, Paper 12 Environmental Management, Module 16, Environment Clearance Process for Category B2 Projects. So, we have already discussed in the previous modules about the process of environmental clearance for Project A and Category B1 projects. In this module, we will discuss introduction, list of category B2 projects, difference between B1 and B2 projects, categorization of B2 projects, qualifications and terms of the experts in DIA and DEEC, procedure for survey, monitoring and allocation of sites for minor minerals, methodology adopted for calculation of mineral potential, procedure for environmental clearance for B2 category projects, and finally, procedure for monitoring of sand mining or riverbed mining. So, introducing, the present module will discuss the environment clearance process for category B2 projects and mining of minor mineral projects procedure of environmental clearance. As discussed in the previous module, the category B has been further categorized as B1 and B2. The category B2 includes the project which do not require scoping and public consultation. The category B2 includes projects of number 1, thermal power plants based on coal, lignite, naphtha and gas of capacity equal to or less than 5 megawatt. The mineral vanification activity listed in the schedule as category B with throughput 90,000 ton per annum involving only physical vanification. The other project included are all non-toxic secondary metallurgical processing industries involving operation of furnaces only, such as induction and electric arc furnaces, submerged arc furnaces, and cupola with capacity more than 30,000 ton per annum but less than 60,000 ton per annum, provided that such projects are located within the notified industrial estates. All stand-alone grinding units listed in the schedule as category B, subject to the condition that transportation of raw material and finished products shall be primarily through railways, are covered under category B2 projects. Apart from these, all chlor-alkali plant with production capacity less than 300 ton per day and located within the notified industrial estate listed in schedule as category B are treated as B2. All new or expansion projects of leather production without tanning and located within a notified industrial area or estate listed in the schedule as category B are treated as B2 category. Single superphosphate plants involving only the activity of granulation of SSP powder are also in category B2. All man-made fiber manufacturing units producing fibers from granules or chips. All aerial ropeway projects listed in schedule as category B should be categorized as category B2. And mining of minor minerals of lease area less than 25 hectare are categorized as category B2 projects. Now, what are the major differences between B1 and B2 projects? The major difference between B1 and B2 projects are that B2 projects do not require scoping, that is, issue of terms of reference. B2 projects also do not require public consultation and environment impact assessment. B2 projects of minor minerals are dealt at district level if the area of mining of minor minerals in stand alone is less than 5 acres, equal to or less than 5 acres, or in cluster less than 25 acres, but each individual having less than 5 acres. Hence, B2 projects can be further categorized as, number 1, projects under the scope of State Environment Impact Assessment Authority, that is SIA, and State Expert Appraisal Committee seek at state level. Number 2, projects under the scope of District Environment Impact Assessment Authority, DIA, and District Expert Appraisal Committee, DEAC. The qualification and terms for expert in SIA and SEEC has previously been discussed in the previous modules. Here we will discuss the qualification and terms for the experts in DIA and DEAC. Number 1, qualification. The person should have at least 5 years of formal university training in the concerned discipline leading to a MA or MSc degree. Or number 2, in case of engineering, technology, architectural discipline, 4 years of formal training course together with prescribed practical training in the field leading to BTech, BE, BArch degree. Number 3, other professional degrees, for example MBA, etc., involving a total of 5 years of formal university training and prescribed practical training. Number 4, prescribed apprenticeship or articleship and pass examination conducted by the concerned professional associations, for example, chartered accountancy. A university degree followed by 2 years of formal training in a university or service academy, for example, MBA, MPA, etc., in selecting the individual professionals, experience gained by them in their respective fields will be taken note of. Expert, a professional fulfilling the qualification discussed with at least 10 years of relevant experience in the field or with an advanced degree, for example, PhD in a concerned field with at least 5 years of relevant experience. Age should be below 70 years. However, in the event of non-availability of paucity of experts in given field, the maximum age of a member may be allowed up to 75 years. Then comes the field experts, experts in mining, geology, hydrology, remote sensing, environment quality, environment impact assessment process, risk assessment, life sciences, marine sciences, forestry and wildlife, environmental economics, biodiversity and river ecology, etc. are considered. Tenure. The maximum tenure of an expert member is for 2 terms of 3 years each. The expert members may not be removed prior to expiry of their tenure without cause and proper inquiry. Then, procedure for environmental clearance for category B2 projects. Here, it is worth to mention that it is the only mining of minor mineral projects which come under either state level or district level depending on the individual area or cluster area of mining. The procedure for environmental clearance at state level, that is B2 category projects, is same as in B1 category projects, except that there is no requirement of terms of reference and public hearing. Hence, to make it easy to understand, the present module will discuss the environment clearance process of B2 projects related to mining of minor minerals only. Before I discuss the procedure, there is a need to understand the procedure for survey, monitoring, and allocation of site for minor minerals methodology adopted for calculation of mineral potential. So, number one, survey procedure for survey, monitoring, and allocation of sites for minor minerals. The size of lease for minor minerals, including river sand mining, is determined by the states as per their circumstances. The district survey reports are prepared as procedure given in Appendix 10 of EIA Notification 2006 amendments. The monitoring of sand mining or riverbed mining is done as per procedure prescribed in Appendix 12 of EIA Notification 2006 amendments. The mining of minor minerals is mostly in clusters, hence EIA and EMP are prepared for the entire cluster wherever required. A cluster is formed when the distance between the peripheries of one lease is less than 500 meters from the periphery of other lease in a homogeneous mineral area. These reports include carrying capacity of the cluster, transportation and related issues, replenishment and recharge issues, geohydrological study of the cluster area. The EIA or EMP is prepared by the state or state-nominated agency or group of project proponents in the cluster or the project proponent in the cluster. Public consultation is done for entire cluster before final EIA or EMP report is prepared. The sites so cleared are sold to the proponents, and the environmental clearance obtained is transferred on the name of the project proponent. The EIA and EMP are required only in case the project is falling under category A or category B, 1 or B2, category A and category B1 projects, not for category B2 at district level projects. Then methodology adopted for calculation of mineral potential. The mineral potential is calculated based on field investigation and geology of the catchment area of the river or streams. As per the site condition and location, depth of minerable mineral is defined. The area for removal of the mineral in the river or stream can be decided depending on geomorphy, morphology, depending on geomorphology and other factors. It can be 50 to 60% of the area of particular river or stream. For example, in some hill states, mineral constituents like boulders, river-borne bajri, sand up to a depth of 1 meter are considered as resource mineral. The district survey report is prepared for each minor mineral in the district separately, and its draft is placed in the public domain by keeping its copy in the collectorate and posting it on district website for 21 days. The comments received are considered and, if found fit, are incorporated in the final report to be finalized within 6 months by the DIA. The district survey report forms the basis for application for environmental clearance, preparation of reports, and appraisal of projects. The reports are updated once every 5 years. Then procedure for environmental clearance for mining of minor minerals including cluster. The step-by-step process used for B2 mining projects is discussed here. Step 1. The state or state-nominated agency applies for clearance to the SEEC or deal with the documents depending on the jurisdiction of the authority to appraise as given in the schematic representation 1. These forms are Form 1, Form 1A, Form 1M as in the appendix 8 for category B2 for less than and equal to 5 hectare or cluster less than 25 hectare of individual capacity less than 5 hectare. Pre-feasibility report and mine plan prepared by the accredited consultants. The step 2 comes the technical review. The processing authority reviews the submitted documents for technical compliance. If the documents are in order, the processing authority places the case for the respective committees, that is SEEK or DEEK. Stage 3. The project is presented before the SEEK or DEEK along with all documents including the district survey report. The SEEK or DEEK scrutinizes the project for its environmental impacts and the proposed environmental management plan. The risk, if any, involved. The risk management plan is discussed. Additional suggestions or recommendations may be given by the SEEK or DEEK. Step 4. If the project is recommended by SEEK or DEEK, as the case may be, the project is processed to the SIA and DIA. These, if satisfied with the recommendations of SEEK or DEEK, recommend the project finally for clearance or appraisal. The processing authority finally issues the environmental clearance. The environment clearance for mining of minerals is valid for 7 years. Then, schematic presentation 1, which discusses the requirements on environmental clearance of minor minerals including cluster situation are discussed here. We can see that the column 1 defines the area of lease, whereas number 2 is the category of project. Column 3 is the requirement of EIA or EMP. Column 4 is the requirement of public hearing. Next column is for requirement of EC. Next column is for who can prepare EIA or EMP. Then who will apply for environmental clearance, and finally authority to appraise or grant environment clearance. Here we can see that environment proposal of sand mining and other minor minerals is done on the basis of individual mine lease. If the area is 0 to 5 hectare, it comes under category B2. The requirements are of Form 1M, PFR and approved mine plan. Public hearing is not required in such cases. However, environment clearance is required. Project proponent can directly apply for EIA or EMP and EC. It will come under the DIA and DEEK. If the area is more than 5 hectares and less than 25 hectares, it comes under category B2. The requirements are Form 1, PFR, and approved mine plan and environment management plan. Public hearing is not required. However, environment clearance is required. EIA or EMP is prepared by the project proponent, and the same is also applied by the project proponent for environment clearance. It comes under the ambit of SEEK and SIA. Then category where the lease area is more than 25 hectares and less than 50 hectares. These cases fall under category B1. Here EIA and EMP are required along with the other forms. Public hearing is also required. Prior environment clearance is also required. Project proponent can apply for EIA or EMP. EC is also applied by the project proponent and falls under SEEK and SIA competency. Cases when the cluster area of mine lease is up to 5 hectares, that is the cases when each individual site has area less than 5 hectares, but the total area of cluster is 25 hectares, it also comes under category B2 and is appraised on the basis of Form 1M, PFR and approved mine plan, EIA or EMP not required. Public hearing is not required. Environment clearance is required. EIA or EMP may be submitted. So, here state agency, group of project proponents or project proponent may prepare EIA or EMP if required. Project proponent has to apply for environment clearance and it comes under the ambit of DIA and DIC. Then finally, procedure for monitoring of sand mining or riverbed mining. The monitoring comes under the following heading: the security feature of transport permit, requirement at mine lease site, scanning of transport permit or receipt and unloading on server, proposed working of the system, checking on route, breakdown of vehicle, tracking of vehicles, alerts or report generation and action review. So, here we have discussed about the category B projects. We conclude that category B2 projects are further divided into one which are under the ambit of SIA and SEEK and another which are under the ambit of DIA and DIC. The projects under the ambit of DIA and DIC are only those projects where the individual lease area for the minor minerals is equal to or less than 5 hectares or less than 25 hectares in cluster, but each individual site shall be equal to or less than 5 hectare. Even if a single site is of more than 5 hectare in this cluster, then this will be treated as category B2, but comes under the ambit of SIA and SEEK. Thank you.